Hey YouTube, Dawson Ryder here. Welcome to my review for the Power Rangers Dino Fury figures of Void King and the Master Mode Gold Ranger. You're probably thinking, Dawson, I've already seen 0.25 of this review. There was basically a long journey of nonsense trying to get to this review. This review is late as it is, as part of my review when I originally recorded this discussed the weird distribution on them, which I'll discuss in a second, but in case you did see this upload go up before and then get pulled down because it was like a half review, basically there was a screw up with the upload file, and I thought that I had fixed it, and I didn't. I was in a hurry to go see the Super Mario Brothers movie, so I forked it up, and then the raw files were deleted, so I could no longer fix it, so I have to re-record it. So, welcome to this pointless story, and people that are just trying to watch this to just watch a random review, they're like, what the hell are you talking about, dude? So let's get into the actual review. So first of all, in my original review, I did talk about why this review is late because of the weird distribution on these guys. I thought they were originally supposed to be with the release of the Knight Armor Red Ranger figure. At least that's when I remember them going up online. I never saw them in person, and like I was never able to get them on Amazon because they were always either sold out or they were like the in-stock, but the in-stock where it's like $35 and it's like, nah, come on, son. So I kept checking for a while and then I low-key just forgot. I don't know what low-key has to do with anything with this, but I'm excited for season two. But anyway, long story short, they finally popped up in stores and they're showing up with the special armored pink and green Rangers. So check out Target, they should be online now and more widely available. I only wanted to bring it up because I don't like the distribution for this stuff. I'm not a Hasbro hater by any stretch of the imagination, but I cannot deny that I miss the, like, clockwork precision for Bandai's figures, where you could know, like, roughly when waves would show up, and it was so much easier as both a collector and a reviewer. But let's get started with this. Let me talk about real quick the keys that these come with first. Oh, had a few too many last night, huh? Gotta keep your eye on the ball. Oh, thank you. Anyway. So this is gold. It's nothing special, it's basically the same key you always get, which is kind of disappointing because, as you'll see here in a second, Void King's is actually pretty sweet, and I think my favorite key, honestly, design-wise, both from Ryu Soldier and Dino Fury, but this is really boring. I think they could have done something at least a little bit different with this. Like, again, come on, son. This is Void King's. Again, it's not gonna be, like, a better design in terms of, like, yeah, the Ryu Soldier ones are cooler to deal with, but this is one of the coolest designs. It's like this awesome Spectre Ghost key. The only, like, sad part about it is like, this is just kind of hollow in the back, but otherwise, it's one of the few times I was actually kind of happy to own one of these. Overall, really neat. I'm now gonna cut to future me recording the sounds of this after I film the review and the morphers, which aren't that special, but, you know, you gotta do it for the contract. Okay, with this one, broken record, but yes, the keys can work with it, but it doesn't have a reader, so they're not gonna do anything different. Oh, it's glitching out. It really... I think that was because I wasn't pointing it in a clear direction. But it's funny that I said it won't do anything different, and then that was the first time I'd ever seen that. But my core point is, it doesn't have a reader. They make it seem like it's going to do different sounds, but it doesn't. It's going to do the same exact thing, just activate the core functions. I mean, in the case of this, the stuff we've seen before, but it does have a bit of a reader in it. Alright, now we're going ghost! Wait, which way do we go ghost? How are we gonna catch him all because he's Danny Phantom? There we go! Alright, and that's about it for that. Now back to Carl with sports. But now we can talk about the actual figures. Let's talk about Gold Ranger first. There's not a whole lot to talk about here. I mean, it's basically, and it really is, the same exact figure as this one. I initially thought they were slightly different because his boots were really shiny, and then I realized his boots were also shiny. Shiny Boot Brothers, you know how it is. That was weird. Anyway, basically it's the same figure. It's just wearing a robe. You know, that's basically the power-up in general. And the robe looks fine. You know, it looks a little bit cheap looking. It looks even a little cheaper looking compared to some other things, but I will give them props for how cool, like, the cloth effect here is on this. And you know, it's a basic figure, though. I'm not saying, like, I'll cut it 100% slack, but it's, you know, an $8, $9 figure, depending on how much you're able to get it for, so it looks as good as it's gonna get, but it's not the best looking. I feel that mostly just the gold plastic looks a little bit cheap, especially since, you know, this does look a little bit cheaper here, but, like, the gold helmet and the boots make the figure actually look pretty good, so this kind of stands out as a little bit more cheap looking, but for a basic figure, I'm personally happy with it for what it is. I wasn't expecting any more than this, but it certainly isn't the coolest looking ones. Like, I think in general, some of the armor ones look a little bit cooler. It is a bit funny here with the sword, which is his only accessory outside of the key. It looks like a Christmas tree because they're just kind of adapting the core colors of it, and it's kind of funny. It stands out a little bit. Some people might find it annoying. I just kind of find it to be funny and charming. But like I said, it's basically the same figure. You're par for the course stuff. It's not going to be as articulated as a Lightning Collection figure or as a figure art, but you get a decent range of leg motion. You have a knee joint here, just a single knee joint. You have arm movement here that goes in and out and all around, but you can't fully move it because of the cape. The cape will come off, though, I'm pretty sure, because it's not attached. Like, I think you'll have to pop off the head or maybe just finagle it and have it give birth out of its... I don't know, that was weird. I don't know where I was going with that, but it's possible to take it off. It's not like the Pink and Green Ranger figures where it's molded onto there or it's not secretly molded on at one part. It's fully loose, so you can take it off, and like the articulation is available. It's just when you have it on, obviously it's a little bit hindered, but you still get some of the range there. And you obviously have the head range as well. You're able to move at 360 and up and down a little bit. So basically the same, just a little bit hindered because of the cape. But yeah, basically, nothing too special to write home about. If you like this mold and you like the Gold Ranger, go ahead and pick it up. Otherwise, it's not a must-have. Now, moving on to this one, which is Void Knight, or Void King, whatever. It's just the Void guy. What's his real name? Ned? No, it's not Ned. I actually can't remember this dude's real name at the moment. Tarek, that's right, because it was like Derek, but it's like, hey, what if we made it weird? Like, anyway. So, the only complaints I can see arising about this guy from fans, and I understand because it's not as accurate, is he's a little bit skinnier in the show. It's not like a huge deal, but I feel like he's got a little more bulk in the show. A little bit skull, too. Also, he's like very translucent, whereas in the show, I think that he comes off a little cross more solid white. So he almost comes across looking like a variant, so I'm waiting for the TVA to come prune him. But while we do that, setting that aside, I actually kind of like the way it looks. You're gonna like the way it looks. Like, I don't know, I just actually kind of dig it. Like, the skinniness, it kind of bothers me maybe a little bit. It almost makes him look like Void Knight's son. But the translucent aspect actually makes him look pretty cool. It lends into this sort of ghostly specter element, which isn't really a part of his character or anything, but, like, you would probably think he's kind of a ghosty-related character based on this stuff if you've never seen the show. Ghosty's kind of a technical term. I'm sorry to use such a big word there. But I like the way it looks, actually. Like, again, with these figures, I'm never expecting the most accurate or the most details, so I'm a little more lenient on it not looking as accurate. I don't know if we'll ever get a Lightning Collection figure of that, but that's where I would expect something more accurate. But for this, I'm just happy to have something for him in my collection, and I think that the translucent spectery vibe actually works and looks pretty cool. And he does come with his two sword weapons, which isn't anything too special. You know, it's just two colors. The translucent is pearly colors, and then this blade here. Although this has kind of a nice, almost pearly shine to it and looks pretty cool. But yeah, I actually just personally dig the unique way this looks. Like, I guess it's because I'm kind of a... Oh, wow, that's embarrassing. That's why this video is brought to you by Bosley. No, I'm just kidding. No, there's no sponsor. I just thought that was a good bit to do there. But this is a separate piece there that sometimes will fall off. It's actually really funny when I got this, like when you get it out of the package, this is separate. This is with the weapons. And I'm like, oh my God, people are going to be so mad they botched this. They forgot this. I'm like, wait, wasn't this on the front of the packaging? So yeah, it is separate. It will come off every now and then. That's mine, though. Maybe yours won't. Your mileage may vary. The articulation is basically the exact same as the Gold Ranger, which is nice. And obviously, he can actually move his arms out because he doesn't have the rope to deal with. Robe to deal with. And then what's nice, too, is you actually have villain articulation on the legs. You know, that used to be a thing where, you know, even if it was a Ranger-esque villain, you would have them just completely stationary, which kind of sucked. But yeah, overall, these are two pretty much par for the course additions to your basic figure waves. You know, if you want a Void Knight figure, I think this is a pretty cool one to have. You know, the Gold Ranger is nothing too special to write home about, but if you happen to like this mode, you know, it's your standard basic figure quality. I think in general, you know, there are some that are lesser quality than others in this line, but I think in general, I'm actually pretty happy with the basic figures. Like, they hit exactly what they're supposed to in terms of the details, and what's nice about them is that even though they're cheaper in general, you know, sometimes they won't look as good, they all feel solid. Sometimes you'll get loose joints, but it's crazy to me that this, like, $9.99 figure feels more solid than the most recent wave of Lightning figures where I broke my Izzy figure two times. That's it for this one, guys. Thank you for being patient and waiting for this review, all five of you that cared again. But until next time, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and climb the steps and ring that bell so you can get notifications for my videos. Dawson Ryder, signing out.